Hey guys, what's up and welcome back to my channel, or if you're new here, welcome to my channel. My name is Sabrina and I would love it so much if you would subscribe. Today's video is going to be a 2019 recap and a 2020 goals list. I really debated on making these videos because they never really hold me accountable like I say they do. I don't really go back and watch the videos until it's time to make a new one, so it's not really necessarily for me per se, but I do really enjoy watching these from other content creators, so that's why I ended up deciding to do it. And I just want to share my life with you guys more. I've been doing more vlogs. I really love being able to be open and honest with you guys, and so this was another way for me to kind of do that and go over the highs and lows and the goals of last year and talk about my goals for the new year coming forward. This is my new setup. This is my first time filming with my ring light. I already filmed this once with my glasses and I think that it's too distracting, so I'm leaving my glasses off for this. Let me know what you guys think in the comments below because I can't see crap. I had to make sure that I was in focus before and hoping that I stay in focus. But let's go ahead and get into my recap and my goals for the past year and the new year. So last year, like I said, I don't think I made a video for this, but I did separate my goals into social media and personal. In the past, I put a lot of restrictions on myself when it comes to numbers and social media and all that. This year, I did not do that. This year, the only thing that I wanted to do was to post content that I'm proud of and not to feel pressured to post. And I think that I did a really good job of that. I didn't stick to any sort of schedule. I posted when I had ideas or when something sparked in my mind or when I wanted to. I didn't feel like, oh, it's Wednesday, so I have to post something. And I feel like that helped me a lot. Obviously, I didn't see a numbers growth really at all, but it took away the stress and it made it fun again to do social media and YouTube, and that's what I wanted. So I'm really proud of myself for kind of taking a step back in that aspect. Within the last couple of weeks or maybe even months, I started doing vlogs on this channel, and I feel like it's really been beneficial for me because I really like sharing my life with you guys, and you guys seem to really enjoy it. So I feel like that also helped. Yes, I have my glasses in my hand so that I can read the notes in between takes. For my personal goals, I did have a little bit more of these. The first one that I said I wanted to do more couple trips with my partner, Jacob. And I feel like we did a really good job of that. We did do a lot of traveling within the last 3 months. We went to Texas and Florida together. We did a lot more family things together, and I'm really fortunate for that. Like I said, I've been doing more vlogs on here, so some of those things are recapped if you guys are curious to watch those, but I do feel like it was pretty awesome for us. I wanted to save up as much money as possible, and at the beginning of the year, I was doing really well, but I did end up buying a house and moving in April, so that took the majority of my savings, and I have not put back into it like I should. We are in the process of planning a wedding. We have not done a very good job of it, so I have to put a fire under my ass to be better at saving because I didn't do as well as I should have there. The next one is I wanted to create art that I was proud of. And this meant for social media, such as YouTube videos or Instagram, but also I wanted to create digital art, do my art, like my passion, what I went to school for. And I feel like within the last couple of weeks specifically, I've really nailed this down, and I'm really proud with the progress I've made just in the last like 3 weeks. And I want to continue that into 2020. The next one may seem like a cheat. I kind of feel like it is cheating, but it's graduate college. I knew that I was going to graduate college in 2019, but towards the end of it, guys, I was really wanting to drop out. I really did. College is really hard. It's not something that I ever want to do again. I do not want to go back. It's just not for me. So I don't see myself ever going back, but I did graduate with a bachelor's in graphic design, and I am really freaking proud of myself for making it through with all the setbacks that I had, which I'll talk about in the future, but I did it and I'm proud of myself. It's done and I'm not going back. The next one may also be a cheat, but it's moving with my partner, Jacob. Like I said, we bought a house, I think we closed on it in April and I moved in May. And I'm really proud with all the progress that we've made. This house is feeling more and more like a home. There's still some things that we need to get done, which I'll talk about for my 2020 goals, but I think we did a really good job at making this house a home. And I'm really thankful that I get to spend my life with my partner in a home that we own. The next one is crazy to me, but it's eat out less, and I put 3 times a week max. Looking now, that seems like an absurd amount. Like, that's so many to eat out 3 times a week. But back when I made this list, I was living in Terre Haute, Indiana. There was fast food places everywhere. There was DoorDash, you could just bring it to me. And because I was working and going to school, I literally had no time to cook. I never cooked at home. So I was eating out literally for every meal. And I can proudly say now that I still eat out for sure, but I don't eat out every meal. We do a really good job at cooking at home, and I'm very, very thankful for the progress that we've made. Because now eating out 3 times a week sounds like an insane number to me, and I'm really proud of myself for doing that, because that was one that I really did not think that I was going to be able to overcome. There were some low points this year though, and I want to make sure that I highlight those too, because I feel like when people do these recaps, they only show the good things, and 2019 was a great year, don't get me wrong, but there were some really low points for me. In March, I did get third and fourth degree burns all over my foot. I spent about 4 days in the burn unit, and I had to have a skin graft. I'm still dealing with all of that stuff. It's been a nightmare. So that was really hard. Like I said, it set me back with my schooling. I had to take like 2 weeks off of school, like 2 weeks off of work. Like, it really set me back in a lot of ways. I had the worst mental health that I can ever remember having, with between moving to a new place and not having any friends here, plus working all the time. I don't have time to make new friends. And so my mental health just declined drastically. I will put a positive to that though. Recently, I got back in with a psychiatrist. I got on medication and things are starting to look up, and I'm really thankful for that. But it was really rough there for a really, really long time. Bouncing off those, I struggled a lot in my personal relationships and also financially. Because I was going through so much with my mental health, I pulled away from a lot of people. And it may seem kind of dumb to say this, but Jacob and I really don't see each other a lot. Even though we're living together in the same house, we don't see each other a lot. Like, today's my day off and he's out doing other things, and we both are working a lot, so we don't get to spend a lot of time together, and it really stinks. So our relationship really drastically declined because of that. My relationships with my friends back home declined because I'm just so busy, I don't have time to reach out, and I feel a lot of guilt because of that. And so there was just a lot of things going on with my personal relationships that were really crappy this year. And money, finances, buying a new house, trying to build, like, make this house be what we want it to be, it takes a lot out of you, on top of trying to plan a wedding. Like, there's just so much going on behind the scenes that I don't always talk about. And so those two things were definitely really stressful. But to finish this off, I want to finish it off with what I hope 2020 brings me. Some of these goals may seem small and not that big, but like I said, if I put numbers on things or if I make things too crazy, I know that I won't accomplish it. So I kind of kept things short and sweet and to the point this year. This year I want to create something every night. Even if it's bad, I want to create something every single night before I go to bed. I want to throw it into my night routine. This can be something that's digital, whether it be typography or designing stuff on my iPad, or whether it be filming a YouTube video or doing an Instagram post. I want to do that every single night so that I can always be creating and growing and learning. And just, if I feel like if I start doing it, then once a day I'll get better and better, and I'm really excited to see like what happens towards the end of 2020 with that. Because going along with that, I want to start selling art in 2020. I've already started doing a lot of planning behind the scenes. I'm going to try to release some stuff on the first of the year, which is hopefully when you're seeing this, you may be seeing it the day before. But I want to start doing that stuff so that I can start selling art, because eventually I want to do content creation full time. And so I really want to start putting my feet to the ground, so to speak. I want to have a weekly date night with Jacob. And like I said earlier, even though we live together, we don't see each other a lot. And this is something that we did before we lived together, is every week we had a date night. It was Saturday. We would go out to dinner and a movie, and I want to start doing that again. Whether it's just staying home and making dinner together, I want to do something every single weekday. We'll set a weekday aside, and I want to be able to spend time with my partner, because I feel like our relationship is lacking very, very much so, because we don't spend time with each other. And I think that if you want to have a healthy, happy relationship, you should always continue to date your partner. So that's what I want to do for 2020. I want to finish our bathroom in 2020. I would like to hopefully have it finished by February. Like I said, I moved in May and the bathroom has not been finished since then. So I definitely want to get it finished before February happens, because I'm tired of having an ugly bathroom and I want to be able to invite people over to my house. That's one of the last things we have to do besides like painting the bedroom. So I want to get that done. The last thing I want to do this year is get fucking married. I know that seems kind of like a cop out, but guys, planning a wedding is a lot of work, and I've really thought about just eloping somewhere and not having a big wedding, because we both have really big families. But it's gonna happen. We're gonna get fucking married. We're gonna have a wedding that we both love, and it's gonna happen. So I'm putting my brain and his brain together, and we're getting it done. We're getting it planned, and we're gonna have a great wedding that we're both really proud of. So that was my recap of 2019 and my goals for 2020. If you guys have created a video like this, please leave a comment down in the description or down in the comments below letting me know. I love watching these. Or if you're not someone who's a content creator, just leave me a comment letting me know your highs, lows, and what you accomplished in 2019 and what you want to accomplish in 2020. I absolutely love reading comments from you guys, so definitely let me know those in the comments below. I will see you guys in my next video. Thank you so much for watching, and have a great day and happy new year. Bye guys.